Now, should we set up straight?
Or should I never set up straight.
With the other. We're supposed to be casual, just chit-chatting. Just three car makers chatting.
Just yeah, we relax, normally right? sit next to each other to
Sandy and Jennifer McGuire and Lisa Spangler. We are here with your designers roundtable. You guys asked some questions on all different social media, and I have pulled them together on my little phone here. And we're going to answer your questions, or at least a few of them. First one is that question everybody always asks. If you were stranded on a desert island, what three items would you bring?
Crafty items.
It can't be chocolate
or donut.
I don't know if that's a craft supply.
Chocolate is essential.
Yeah, chocolate is essential. On a desert island, it might melt.
That's good.
But I'm trying to think of things that we could get off the desert island with, if we wanted to get off, or do we want to stay there?
Crafty. At least for a few days, I want to stay.
Yeah.
And I'll be napping, but.
Okay.
Stamps. Does it have to be a particular stamp?
I don't know. Does stamps plural count? Do we need to have a stamp? Do we need like H-E-L-P? So we'd have to have
S-O-S.
A help stamp? Well, S-O-S would be two stamps. That's true.
But you need an ink.
Get an ink, yeah.
AF-101 Hero Arts Black Dye Ink.
Because that would be seen from way up high.
Yes. Yeah. The best black ink. You need that.
Yeah.
And then you need some stamps.
Yeah. And
you're all about escaping. I'm all about staying for a few days.
I guess we could go either direction. How would you?
I think I would get some neon so that then maybe the plane would see the neon.
Okay, you guys don't have kids. I'm on the island relaxing because the kids aren't on the island. So I'm wanting to stay and you guys are looking to go.
Yeah. This might be the one time I would bring glitter. Because you could make things reflective to catch the light. But you can only leave when you're ready to use those objects to leave.
So you could stay as long as you want.
So you could stay a while, just not employ them as an SOS.
Okay.
Is that
fine? That works.
Fair?
Okay.
I'll take that. Oh, these crazy questions. All right, let's see what's next on the list. What was your least crafty job you've ever had?
I was an engineer and I designed feminine hygiene products.
Wow!
Least crafty.
It would not be creative,
the most fun.
However.
Not the most fun. But yes, I worked at Procter & Gamble. And so that was one of the many projects. Not all of them were that way, thankfully. But yes, you may want to edit that out.
Wow. Okay.
So I could just say my least crafty job was an engineer at Procter & Gamble.
Yeah, but I think the other answer was more entertaining.
Yeah. I've got some good stories. Ask Lisa. They're funny.
That'll be a CHA video. How about that? Yeah. We'll ask her more questions about that later.
Follow-up questions.
Yeah. Lisa. Mine would be at the pet store. I had to work at a pet store when I was a kid. My dad got me the job there. And the worst part about it was the day that I had to hold a tarantula. I had to put my hands out like this. And the store owner put the tarantula in my hands, and I went, "Ah, that's it! I quit!" And I left, and I was never to be seen in that pet store again.
And you just dropped it on the floor.
I just dropped it on the floor and walked away. I was freaked out.
Poor tarantula.
That was a big, big, big tarantula. It's like this big.
Yeah,
spiders. Spiders. All right. How about you?
I guess some people out there probably know that I used to work at IBM. And I worked on security software to only let people log in at certain times. And I was down writing code in the operating system itself. So, not even anything you can see. Like, if you write a web program, you can actually look at the screen and see it. But this was like deep down in the Linux kernel.
Wow. And
it was Linux.
And now you glue paper together.
Yeah, now I glue paper together!
Yay!
It's like, thanks for paying for that college education, Mom.
Yeah. No kidding. All right, let's see what else is on our list. Biggest craft fail.
Biggest craft.
Any craft disasters.
Oh my. Every day.
Using glitter. with the ceiling fan on high. And it went all over my husband's cell phone, and it stuck in between the keys. And I tried to get it all off, but he didn't know, but he used it, so he's holding it up, and he got glitter all over his face.
No, that's awesome. That's awesome.
Wow.
Did you tell him?
Yeah, but for days, like, he was getting glitter on his face, and he would come home from work with glitter on his face, and,
That's a good one.
So yeah, don't, get, if you do use glitter,
which you shouldn't for operation
should,
right
yes,
now,
absolutely. You should not, but if you do, don't have your ceiling fan on, especially on high.
I'm going to have to, Lisa has not seen my glitter videos, so I'm going to link her up to the glitter videos. She knows how to put the rubber gloves on all the way up to the elbows and the goggles and everything. So what's your craft fail? All of you OWHers who have been around for a while probably know about the hula girl. There was a, I did a stump sandy card, and in that, like back in the beginning, people used to send in a piece of pattern paper. And they sent in this really hideous pattern paper that I pulled out of the envelope randomly live on air and had to make a card with this. And it was that paper, that really thin stuff from, what's that site that you get all the craft, or the party stuff from?
Oriental Trading.
Oriental Trading, yes. Ah, so it was that really thin, super thin, super cheap, but it had this hula girl on it. And I had to try to make a card that was decent out of this hula girl paper, and it's like this famous like craft fail, and it's documented on YouTube. So my tip would be don't ever document your craft fail on YouTube, because it'll be seen forever.
Forever.
Never goes away.
Huh. Craft fail. I've got lots. I think it's a daily occurrence in my room. However, the most memorable one was when Colin was a baby, and when they're newborns, like, they're so easy. I think they're easy when they're, before they know they can be bad. And so I had him in a little baby Bajoran. I was wearing him, and I was crafting. And when my husband came home, he's like, "How was your day?" And I'm like, "Oh, we've just been hanging out." And I didn't know, but he had two gems stuck to the back of his head. So it was clear that I had been making stuff. Not that it was a problem, but it was like really evident. And he had gems on his head.
Nice.
Yep.
Very nice.
And he was probably 10 days old.
Those gems turn up everywhere.
Oh, and they're on the bottom of my feet
yes.
all the time.
Yes.
I have a wood floor now, and if I walk around in socks, yep. click, like I find
click,
everything.
Click, click, it's like tap yep. shoes.
Yes, it is. Or I find them in Sierra's fur.
Oh,
like a dog will just pick them up with her tail or whatever and whack something with them. All right, two more questions. One is, how do you start a card? Do you start with an image, a paper, sketch? What do you start with?
I guess the answer is yes. I start with all of those. Sometimes I get an idea for a card when I don't have time to stamp. So then I do a sketch. But sometimes I get this new cool piece of paper and it's like, I want to use this paper. And so then I start with the paper. Sometimes I get a new stamp that's really cool. And so I start with the stamp or ink. Ink too.
Yeah, new product.
Yeah, a new color combo. And I get like, oh, Tadpole looks great with the next great thing, neon red. And I have to use those together. So just, it all depends. Sorry.
So usually something new.
Yeah, something new.
Yeah.
Usually.
I'm the same way.
Yeah. If I get an idea out of the sky.
Yeah. I get my best ideas when I'm laying in bed at night. Trying to go to sleep, listening to my husband sleep soundly because he falls asleep like that. So I remember that, and then the next day I find something new that I've been dying to use and I put them together. So it's usually like an idea I had and something brand new and I put them together. But I rarely sketch. What I'll do is like quickly stamp it onto a piece of paper the size of a card and take a picture with my phone. Or I lay it all out on a card, like the pieces, the stamp and the die, and then I take a picture with my phone, and that's like my sketch, as opposed to drawing it out. I save time with it.
Cool. If I'm just doing random stuff for my blog or for the troops or whatever, I usually start with an image, because, you know, coloring fiend. And so I start with that, and then I find stuff that goes with it. But when I'm gonna do my weekly videos or something, I try to come up with whatever the hook is gonna be. So whether it's a technique, or, you know, a new stamp or a new something, you know, or just being goofy, because you guys know I like to be goofy. So it kind of depends on what I'm doing, what I start with. And
I think it also, this being our job, sometimes we just, the card starts because we need to use a certain product.
Yeah,
you can. But I think those are really fun because you kind of are challenging yourself. When I have free reign and can do whatever I want for fun, I'm like a deer in the headlights. And wouldn't you need your Copics on that island?
Yeah, I probably would.
Yeah, if we were all on the same island, we could bring 9 things.
Yeah,
that's right.
Then we're set for a long time.
Exactly.
And I, all your SOSs you send out, I can hide.
Totally kidding. And I wonder if we could bring things in quantity, so we'd have to bring like cases of paper.
Yeah.
Or like
a pallet.
A pallet of chocolate.
Pallet.
There we go. So we have our foods.
That's lemon donuts. Oh, lemon donuts.
Good.
I never got a lemon donut.
You didn't?
Did not.
Hero Arts just brought in a food truck of incredible food, and the dessert was lemon donuts. But they gave us the dessert before we ate, which was fantastic. But then I wanted some more after we ate. But they were delicious. So that's why we're talking about lemon donuts.
And I was filming your tour video.
And she missed out on the donuts. I probably ate them.
I did. Not that I need a lemon donut, but next time.
They're good.
Next time I come to California.
They were terrible. Be glad you missed them.
Oh, I'm so glad they were awesome. All right, last question is, who do you typically send cards to? And do you have any good stories about writing back and forth with people, or who you write cards to?
I send mine to friends, mostly crafty friends. But I send a lot of my cards out. And my oldest stepdaughter is in college, so I've sent her a ton of cards. And in fact, I've gotten a bunch of my friends to send her cards. The funniest story about sending cards is my grandma. She lived to be 101. She died a few years ago, but I sent her cards a lot. And when she died, I went to the nursing home and they showed me all the cards that she had. And that touched my heart. But then when I was looking through them, I started laughing because any card that didn't open normal, like a normal card, like if it was a trifold or if it was like a flip thing that I like to do a lot, she would just tear it because she was confused because it didn't open like a normal Hallmark card, and she got confused and just would rip. So half of them were ripped, just torn apart just because she, you know, she was 100. She couldn't figure it out. But that made me smile too. So
yeah.
When I saw that she kept them all, I remember that made me feel good about taking the time to send a handmade card, because I don't think she would have kept a bunch of store-bought cards.
Yeah.
So.
Yeah. My grandma had kept her cards, too. See? I think grandmas must like keeping cards. Yeah.
So did she tear hers?
She didn't tear hers, good. But towards the end, I actually got to hand-deliver her a card. And she opened it twice, and she told me, first time she opened it, and she was like, oh, this is so great. And then she carefully put it in the envelope. And then about an hour later, she saw the envelope on the table next to her, and she opened it again.
Oh, that's great again.
So it was 2 surprises for one. But yeah, I guess, I don't know, I send cards to my dad and my sister. I'm terrible at sending cards to friends. Sorry, friends. I'm so bad.
Love you, friends. But
I make a card. I have it all planned out, this special birthday card. And then it gets lost on the avalanche in my desk. So,
well, one of the things that I found helped me send more cards is when I finish a card, I have a container where I categorize them, like thinking of you, or 4K, or get well, or whatever. And I fill them up, and then I seem to use them more because I can quickly grab them. And if you do that, if you find you're getting too many of a certain topic that you don't think you're going to end up using, you could send a handful in.
Good idea.
There you go.
She's thinking.
Yeah.
Well, for me,
I try to think once more.
My cards go to the troops, as you guys know, all my letters that I write. I have a whole stash of cards. I have a box that's about yay long full of cards that I've made for me to use. And they just sit there right now. I'm probably going to open an Etsy store and you can buy the card that I should have sent you.
And then they can send it back to you. To send it.
It'd be awesome. But I write a letter, a handwritten letter, in every box to the troops. So with 200 a month, my little hand gets a little tired. So that's why you guys don't get any handmade cards from me. I probably should think about that more and try to organize myself so that I do that instead of having this giant box sitting around waiting for me to send them to somebody. So, well, thank you, ladies, for a little fun chat. And thank you guys for taking a few minutes to watch. And we will see you another time.